So now I want to change the temperature. Nearly I am changing here the temperature 773 kelvins. How much of here the 773 kelvins? So that equilibrium also changes. Why? Because we changed which one here the temperature. Whenever we are changing the temperature, compulsory the equilibrium also changes. On which side? Okay, here the temperature is increased. Okay, so that means how much of the increased here? Nearly 173 kelvins are increased. Now here to nullify is nothing but compulsory the chemical equilibrium always shift for the decreasing of the temperature. Okay, why? Because we are increased. So always the equilibrium thought that one, here the temperature is increased. That means compulsory chemical equilibrium changes. So compulsory you have to decrease here the temperature. That means the chemical equilibrium is always shifted to here the decrease side of the temperature. Okay. For example, I will explain with, for example, human beings or nothing but we. Whenever we are attacked by the viral fever or anything fever. So in that situation, our body temperature increases. Our body temperature increases. So whenever the temperature increases, all the metabolic reactions in our body also totally changes. Okay, but our body compulsory it needs to decrease our temperature, to decrease the, our temperature, and continuously as before fever, what is the temperature? So our body always converts like that. That means our body first of all present in the equilibrium. So whenever the viral attack is there, simultaneously the increasing of temperature takes place. Okay, so whenever the temperature takes, our body always tries to decreasing the temperature to recover as it is before fever effect. Okay, like that, same as it is chemical equilibrium is also. Normally chemical equilibrium affected by the temperature, pressure, concentration. Whenever we are changing those effects compulsory, the chemical equilibrium also shifts. Okay, to nullify that change, to cancel that change, and as it is before, whenever the changing, when before changing the concentration, temperature, and as well as pressure. Okay, before like that. So that is called as here the Lechatliers principle. I think you understand. It is nothing but simple words. Whenever the changes occurs, the equilibrium shifts to nullify the change or cancel the change. So that is called as here the Lechatliers principle. Okay, what is the definition of the Lechatliers principle? If a chemical equilibrium is subjected to change in temperature, concentration, and pressure, then the equilibrium of that reaction, the equilibrium of that reaction is always shifted towards to nullify the change of the effect, to nullify here the change of effect. Okay, whenever we are increasing the temperature, equilibrium shifted towards here the decreasing of the temperature. Whenever we are increasing the pressure, the equilibrium shifted towards here the decreasing side of the pressure. Okay, as it is concentration also, whenever the concentration increases, the shifting of the equilibrium also to decreasing side of the concentration, to reach the normal position, to reach the before affecting of the change, like that. So that is called as here the Lechatliers principle. Okay, so now here the how many factors the Lechatliers principle we are using? Temperature, concentration, and pressure. Okay, I will explain with each and every factor. Why? Because those only important. First of all, I am taking here the pressure effect. I am taking which one here? The pressure effect. Very, very important. So, effect of pressure. So, always pressure of effect is depends upon here the volume. That means if you want to explain pressure effect for the chemical equilibrium, compulsory you have to depend upon which one here? The volume. Okay, why madam we have to depending upon the volume? On the volume basis only we can says, is it high pressure, low pressure, or increasing of pressure, decreasing of pressure, according to Boyle's law. According to which law here? The Boyle's law. Okay, so that's why for the purpose of pressure effect, always we have to depend upon here the volume. Volume is nothing but here the number of molecules. Volume is nothing but which one here? The number of molecules. Based upon the number of molecules, we have to say what is the necessary condition. That means what is the shifting of pressure takes place? Increasing of pressure or decreasing of pressure? And that is nothing but high pressure or the low pressure. Those only explained by depending upon which one here? The volume. Okay, I can explain with one example for the pressure effect. Whenever, so pressure effect always explained by which one here, the depending upon here the value. Okay, volume is nothing but which one here, the number of molecules. Okay, so between the pressure and volume, always which type of the relationship present? Inversely proportional. Which type of the here? Inversely proportional. So V is nothing but which one here, the number of molecule. Okay, so now whenever I am increasing the pressure, then our chemical equilibrium always shifted towards decreasing of the volume. Which one here, the decreasing of the volume. So decreasing of the volume is nothing but here the decreasing of number of molecules. Whenever pressure is increases, the chemical equilibrium shifted towards which one here, the decreasing side of the volume. Okay, so that means whenever the pressure is increases, that should be shifted to here the decreasing of volume. So whenever you are taking here the decrease in the pressure, that should be takes here which one here, the increasing of the volume. Which one here, the increasing of the volume. Okay, so I think you understand here the pressure effect is always depending upon which one here, the volume. So volume is nothing but here the number of molecules. Okay, and also I can explain with the simultaneous. That means whenever the volume is decreases, whenever volume is increases, okay, whenever the volume is increases, chemical shift, chemical equilibrium also shifted to which one here, the decrease in the pressure. Decrease in the pressure is nothing but which one, it is the favorable, low pressure is favorable for this one. What is the favorable here, the low pressure of the chemical equilibrium is favorable. Okay, for example, I am taking one of the chemical equilibrium. Okay, in that chemical equilibrium, from reactant side to product side, volume is increased. For that kind, the chemical equilibrium is always shifted towards here the which side, which favorable side here, the low pressure favorable side. Okay, next of all, whenever you are taking here the volume, whenever the volume is here the decreases, whenever the volume is decreases, so that is always shifted towards which one here, the high pressure. Shifted towards which one? High pressure. Okay, so that is nothing but here the volume is increased, means that chemical equilibrium necessary here the low pressure. If the volume is decreased, that should be needs which one here, the high pressure. Okay, it is only which effect here, the pressure effect. Which effect here, the pressure effect. So second effect, what it is here, the temperature. I am taking which one here, the second effect here, temperature. Okay, temperature effect. So based upon the temperature effect, already we know that one, reactions are two types, exothermic reactions, endothermic reactions. Exothermic reactions are nothing but a heat energy evolving reactions. Endothermic reactions are nothing but heat energy absorbed reactions. Okay, so those are here only the based upon the temperature. Now our chemical equilibrium, temperature is increased. So whenever the temperature is increased, compulsory the chemical equilibrium should be shifted towards absorbing of temperature, absorbing of heat energy. So absorbing reactions are nothing but, what are those here, the endothermic reactions. Okay, whenever the temperature is increases, that means it always, the chemical equilibrium is shifted towards which one here, the endothermic type. If the temperature is decreased, if the temperature is decreased, that should be shifted towards which one here, the exothermic. Here the temperature is increased, so that's why there should be chemical equilibrium always here the absorb the energy. Whenever the absorbing takes place, that reaction called as here the endothermic. If the temperature is already decreased, It has some particular temperature, but we are changing the decreasing the temperature. So that's why always this equilibrium consider has to increase temperature. Increase temperature is nothing but evolving of heat energy. So evolving of heat energy is nothing but here it is called as exothermic reactions. Okay. So based upon here the Lechatliers principle, what are the main factors? First factor I am explained here, the pressure effect. Second factor it is here, the temperature. Third one, last one, what it is here, the concentration. Last one, what it is here, the first factor, sir, it is the third factor, what it is here, the concentration. Okay, so here the based upon the concentration, we have to say the shifting of chemical equilibrium to the forward reaction side or to the backward reaction side. For example, I can take one reaction. So general equation, A plus B gives rise to the C plus D. It is called as the forward reaction. It is called as the backward reaction.